Good afternoon. The first item of business is time for reflection. And our time for reflection leader today is Rabbi Eliran Shabo, Honorary Jewish Chaplain for the Scottish Universities.
Presiding Officer, Member of the Scottish Parliament, thank you very much for the opportunity to address you today. 2 weeks ago, Jews worldwide celebrated Passover, commemorating the Exodus and the end of centuries of Israelite slavery in Egypt. The less familiar part comes the following day, the counting of 49 days of Omer until the next Jewish festival, Shavuot, the celebration of receiving the Torah, the Jewish law. While this tradition appears in the Torah as a commandment from God, Rabbi Nissim from Girondi, a Torah commentator from 14th century Spain, claimed that the Israelites started count spontaneously and anticipatingly. This counting is quite unique. Firstly, we count up, not down. Today, for instance, is the 14th day of counting. Second, we count with anticipation for law, for meaning and responsibility. Rabbi Lord Jonathan Zaks, the former chief rabbi of the United Kingdom, explained that when a nation of slaves received freedom, they may be physically free, but they are still not a free society. In his words, a free society requires the strength and the rule of law. There is such a thing as constitution of liberty. Hence, we need to grow and develop in preparation for the next step for receiving responsibility and understanding the meaning of our lives. In these 50 days of counting, we prepare ourselves daily. We consider how to be better and how we can improve our deeds. Indeed, you may refer to these days as time for reflection. It is not coincidence that these days of counting come at the beginning of spring, a season of renewal marked by blossoming life and the promise of abundant harvest. Farmers anticipate the harvest, hoping that this season will be fruitful and profitable. There is a daily process of observation and growing in nature as in ourselves. The counting of the Omer teaches us to set a positive goal and prepare accordingly. But it also teaches us that the celebration of freedom is tied with the celebration of responsibility. And in past generations, when freedom was taken away from our ancestors, they remained free in their minds as they already held the manifestation of it in their hearts. In conclusion, as we reflect the significance of counting the Omer and the journey from slavery to freedom, let us remember that true liberation is not merely the absence of chains, but the embrace of responsibility and the pursuit of meaning. May this season of growth and introspection inspire us all to cultivate a society founded on the principles of justice, restraint, and the Jewish law. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Reverend.